Savannah Resources is a UK-based multi-commodity and multi-geographic development company. Its main activities include exploring for copper in Oman, as well as enhancing its heavy mineral sands project in Mozambique. And it's just announced the appointment of two non-executive directors who will be based in Oman. Well, for a few more details on just what's going on, I'm joined on the line by Savannah's chief executive, David Archer. David, thanks very much for your time. Tell me a bit more, first of all, about these two appointments. What's the thinking behind it?
Yeah, sure. Well, the two appointments are of two Omani nationals, Mr. Maqbool Sultan, Mr. Imad Sultan, who are very well-respected individuals in the Omani business network. They represent the Al Marjan group, and they bring enormous business experience, expertise, and know-how around operations in Oman, and are very sort of influential on the Omani business scene. So they really do sort of both underscore our interest in the pursuit of our Omani and the projects, and really do help credential us as a very sort of serious player in the Omani resources sector.
And Al Marjan, they're quite a significant investor in Savannah, aren't they?
So the Al Marjan Group has just under a 30% interest in Savannah, and that makes them the largest shareholder in the company. So very appropriate that they're represented by two senior representatives like Maqbool and Imad Sultan.
One thing I was curious to ask is, having Omani representation a nice to have, or is it more of a must have when operating in Oman?
I think it's obviously nice to have, but even better, it really is a must-have, I think, in many ways. Mm-hmm. I think having both local ownership and a local representation on the board, I think will be sort of very key in terms of credentialing it and helping us move our projects forward into development. So I think it's a key point of differentiation. And we're sort of very conscious of presenting as local a face in whatever geography it is that we're actually operating in, whether it's Oman or Mozambique, for example.
Well, let's just touch on your interests in Oman. You've got three copper blocks there, is that right?
Yeah, that's right. The blocks 4, 5, and 6 projects, which really sort of cover the historically the most productive part of the Oman ophiolite belt. The ophiolite belt hosts a series of copper deposits and copper prospects, and has produced historically over 250,000 tonnes of copper over a number of decades, and even more historically, it's probably the source of much of the copper that originally started the Bronze Age many thousands of years ago. So lots of very deep history with copper.
And you're looking to commence production, is it late next year?
Yep, that's right. Both from underground and open cut operations, we're sort of focusing very much on these high-grade VNS ore bodies, which are amenable to both underground and open cut mining, but which are quite high grades, which means that you've effectively got a lower cost of production. So these are very sort of durable projects, have very good economic characteristics, and they can be brought into production quite quickly, and will be sort of certainly leveraging off some of the really fabulous advantages of operating in Oman. Very low fuel costs, naturally, as an oil producer, but a very good infrastructure network as well. These mines are literally only a few kilometres from tarmac roads, and only a few score of kilometres from the export port of Sohar, which is in itself a global hub for copper concentrate blending. So lots of great advantages for us doing what we're doing in Oman.
Well, certainly. And what kind of exploration targets have you set yourself?
Well, we published some formal exploration targets a number of months or so ago, and we think we can sort of shoot for tonnages of up to 30 million tonnes in aggregate over a number of deposits. So So we're looking at a hub and spoke approach, having a central processing facility to use ore from a series of mines. And because of the high grade nature of that ore, the projects are very sort of amenable to a hub and spoke development like that.
And David, just before we let you go, aside from Oman, you've also got exploration projects on the go in Mozambique and Finland. How are things going there?
Yeah, well, in Finland, we're very excited that we're moving much closer to obtaining Mozambican government approval for our joint venture with Rio Tinto. We're looking to combine our own project, the Jangamo project, with their Mutamba project. And in aggregate, a very, very sort of large exploration target that's been identified there, and we think it's one of the largest accumulations of mineral sands on the east coast of Africa. So, something of real value and something we're very sort of keen to get stuck into with drilling this year. Secondly, we also launched an initiative in Finland where we've secured two areas of a known lithium-bearing pegmatite. And we're keen to get on the ground there and to demonstrate the appeal of these things and add a very exciting lithium element to our story as well. We like lithium, we like copper, and we think they'll be two key commodities in terms of the new energy matrix that's developing internationally around renewable energy, storage of that renewable energy, and its application in electric vehicles.
Well, sounds like there's plenty happening, David. Good talking to you. Thanks for updating us.
Okay, great pleasure.